If you use QR codes with your smartphone, how safe is your data? Hey everybody, I'm Bill, the Hill Country Prepper, and I want you to be informed so that you can be prepared. Just how secure is your data? Especially if you use those QR codes that we all see everywhere now these days. I want to tell you about a report coming out this week out of Australia. The court ruling in the Australian state of Victoria has exposed that the government lied and tried to cover up details over the security of the private information of millions of Australians. Since the start of the pandemic, the state government assured the citizens that any details that they shared would only be used for public health purposes. Now, however, it's being reported that personal information shared with contact tracers or through the QR codes does not have absolute protection. Now, the program's called COVID Safe, and this is a digital contact tracing app that's used by Australia since April of 2020. The way it works is there's a couple different ways. Citizens can download an app onto their smartphone, and then through the use of these QR codes at different locations, they can check in when they arrive at a location, such as a restaurant or something like that. And then they check out again via this QR code. Now, there's another way that they can do it. If they don't have a smartphone or they don't want to do it that way, they can go on to the Victorian government website, enter in all their personal information, and then they'll receive a card that has the QR code on it. And when they go into these locations, such as restaurants and different venues, they can scan their code and it's used for contact tracing in case there is a known case of the coronavirus at that location. Then the government will know who is there and they'll be able to contact them. Sounds like a good idea, right? Now, this app contains a lot of personal data about the individual, and it's only supposed to be kept in the government system for 28 days before it's purged. But now that purging is not actually happening as planned. Now, this report that's come out this week has revealed that the government was not only aware of the lie, but had actively tried to deceive the public by gagging release of the truth related to the security of the private information. Hey guys, if you're getting information out of this video, why don't you go ahead and press down on that thumbs up button and give it a like. And if you're not a subscriber yet, why not? Subscribe right now and hit that notification bell too. That way you'll get notified each and every time I upload some new content. So do that right now. Now, the head of the COVID response for the government launched a legal bid to have the court case kept secret for 5 years. That's 5 years, people. He wanted to do this to stop the damaging revelation from being made public. Now, documents published by the news outlet locally there in Australia, the Herald Sun, revealed that Jerome Wymer, the COVID commander is what he's called, argued to the court that public confidence in the state's contact tracing system was of greater importance than telling the citizens of Victoria about the threat that their personal information could be obtained by others. Do you catch that? The system's more important than them knowing that their data's not safe. Now, this news came to light as the department applied to the court to put the brakes on a workplace safety watchdog group seeking access to contact tracing information as part of its probe into the state's hotel quarantine fiasco. Melbourne's quarantine hotels have been identified as a major source of the deadly second wave of COVID last year. Now, when the Australia ban of travelers returning to the country came into effect in 2020, all travelers returning to Australia from outside the country were required to isolate for 14 days in designated hotels. Thus, they call it hotel quarantine. And there were a lot of things that went wrong with that, and I'll not get into all that. There was a lot of different shenanigans going on. Just leave it to say that safety protocols were not followed, and that's why this workplace safety group got involved. Now, as the State Department pushed for the details to be quashed from the public view, documents have revealed that the state's health and safety regulator argued the court should not assist the public in being misled. Now, that group accused the State Department of seeking the suppression, quote, to prevent the public from knowing the true story that information provided through contact tracing may have been disclosed. Here's the question. If the Victorian government would lie to cover up disclosure of their citizens' personal information, do you think that your local, state, and federal government won't do the same? You guys watch this video next for more information. Have a blessed day.